Betty Davis is the lonely widow who takes a street-tough teenager into her home.
Put your feet on the floor.
She gave him his first lessons in love and human respect.
Big deal.
He opened her eyes to the harsh realities of life. Realities that were soon to become her own.
An eviction notice.
And when the chips were down...
You're sick, don't you see that?
The kid returned her kindness.
I'm gonna take care of her.
They had nothing in common but a will to survive.
You saved my life.
And no one to save but each other. A tale of a truly unlikely team. But what a team they made. Betty Davis stars with Ernest Harden Jr. in White Mama.
Carter is the slave name that was given to my forefathers and was passed on to me. Hurricane is the professional name that I acquired later on in life.
Reuben Hurricane Carter has defeated the wonder...
One thing I could do and the only thing was box.
Can you believe that black punk? He thinks he's champion of the world.
We're looking for two Negroes in a white car.
Any two will do.
Look carefully, sir. Are these the two men who shot you?
He said no.
Take another look, sir.
Reuben Carter, you are sentenced to be imprisoned for the remainder of your natural life.
I'm innocent. I've committed no crime. Crime's been committed against me.
I'm dead. Just bury me.
Your first book, huh?
16th round.
Reuben Hurricane Carter.
You know what, Les? Sometimes we don't pick the books we read, they pick us.
Dear Mr. Carter, I read your book. I would like to come and visit you.
You think I killed those people, son?
No, no, I know you didn't.
Two juries found him guilty, Les.
But the man's innocent. That he's been in jail 15, 16 years is not right.
It's very important. Transcend the places that hold us.
Can you see us?
Yeah.
You could understand I'm not leaving without you.
50 years old.
Your Honor, this case was built on a foundation of lies.
20 years spent locked up in a cage. Justice, that's all I ask. Hate put me in prison. Love's gonna bust me out.
Thank you.
Welcome home, son.
Welcome, Carl.
What should I call you?
Mom and Dad works.
Thanks for helping me, Dad.
You bet. Just promise me you'll put it away when you're done with it.
I will.
He has terrible bruises on his arms.
I don't believe what you are implying.
I'm not implying anything. Except maybe you need a little patience.
We don't know anything about Carl. He is like a boarder in an old-time boarding house. He sleeps here, he eats at our table, but we don't know anything about him.
Yeah, he's adjusting.
Just like everyone else does.
Our children are our lifeblood. We must not give up on them.
I need to tell you something. When Carl and I were here alone, I was in the shower, and I didn't know he was in the bathroom.
He threatened to kill me if I told.
Mom, we gotta send him back.
She's always mad at me. I just want her to like me.
Carl, your mom loves you. We all love you.
I think Carl killed Lady.
I know Carl just needs a little bit of attention.
The one time I ask you to support me.
Don't touch me!
Jaren, your brother is really sick.
No, he's evil.
He is damaged. He is disturbed. He is not evil.
Talking to your neighbors to get some info on a recent crime. The stabbing of a young girl. Any of your children go to Anabar Middle School or know any students from there?
You want to help him. You help him somewhere else. Not here. Not under the same roof with my children. Carl!
I'm okay. I'm not scared. I'm okay. I can do this. I'm not scared.
You owe me!
Back off the cab, lady!
Going nowhere.
Back
off!
Honey! Mommy loves you.
Get me back! You hear me? You hear me?
When I was 8, I was taken away from my mother when she was arrested for drugs. By the time I was 12, I was in my 10th foster home. And all that time, that letter was the only thing I ever got from you, Dad. I need a place to stay for a little bit.
It's clear that you are not ready to assume the responsibility of motherhood.
Suffer because you're suffering.
Where was God when I was suffering all these years? You think you know me? You don't know anything!
20 years ago, I opened my home as a shelter.
Hey, everybody, this is Apple.
Your mother will not give her consent for you to be here.
She will never let me go.
No, no!
You don't know what I wanted out of life.
Look at me now. I deserve a second chance.
I am done being passed off as someone's case number. I want out of the system!
It's okay now. I got you.
It's crazy how you can go and live with strangers and feel like your family.
When faith is shattered.
I want our marriage to survive this, but we can't grieve separately.
I don't believe in God anymore.
Where do lost souls go to pick up the pieces?
Welcome to Isle du Soleil.
You wouldn't be the first guest we've had who's running from something.
We gotta help these people, Eric.
And restore all hope.
My husband, he's lost his faith.
Faith is one of those things that even if you felt you've lost it, it never loses you.
Runaway Island premieres Easter Sunday at 9 p.m. on Aspire.
Do you really know what it feels like to be me? Pretend you don't care what they say behind your back? Is she on drugs?
No, please!
You wanna kill the voices in my head? The pain never leaves me. My sickness only feeds the pain.
Based on the book from best-selling author Rashonda Tate Billingsley, The Secret She Kept, a TV One original movie, premieres Sunday, July 10th at 7 on TV One.
If you focus on your breathing, it'll bring you out of your mind and back into your body.
Come on.
Just know that you are not alone.
Crime today is an American epidemic.
There ain't no killer.
The system doesn't work for people who can't afford to defend themselves.
The whole neighborhood know what happened. The whole neighborhood know you grabbed the wrong guy.
I'm an innocent man!
I don't know you the way a mother should know her son.
Everyone saying you did something. After a while, you start to question yourself.
I'll work for free if you take a look at his case.
How are we gonna afford this?
You want me to leave him?
They gonna keep me in here until I say I kill that man. You know I would die before I do that.
We're gonna keep fighting for you.
You got your family, you got your life. Why are you still wasting your time on me?
It's not just about you. It's bigger than that.
If Colin Warner lived in Texas
or Louisiana, he would have been executed long ago.
Longer sentences? More prisons.
They took everything from me.
More police.
Everything.
I can't just pretend this situation doesn't exist.
Well, this situation exists too.
The truth is going to come out.
Can't leave an innocent man in jail.
I'm gonna take you home.